Hello students of class 11. Welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidya Bhavan High Secondary School. This video is for class 11 nutrition and the chapter that I am going to continue today is the vitamins. And this video is the part 9 from this chapter. In the previous video, I have completed the parts of vitamin D. In this video, we will start with the vitamin E. So the vitamin E, usually called, the chemical name of it is tocopherol. Tocopherol. Okay. So vitamin E was first recognized by the Evans and Bishop in 1922. And dietary factors obtained from plants and which can help in reproduction, because the vitamin D have a very important role in the reproduction, and due to the deficiency of that of it, the various kind of the reproduction problem can be seen, or sometimes the people became infertile due to the deficiency of the vitamin E. So next, the chemistry of it, like the vitamin E is a genetic term, it included the compounds that exhibit biological activity, and it is called tocopherol. Toco means childbirth. The tocopherol, if we break down this part, the toco means childbirth, and the feral means to bear. That means vitamin D, E both help in both functions, like to bear the child and also to form the child, to give the birth of the child. In both part, the vitamin E is used. So it is a very important part. Like if the vitamin E deficiency, we have done many practicals projects on it, and the various functions and the projects and the studies are doing all over the world, where it is showing that vitamin E, without the vitamin E, the implantation of the embryo cannot be happen. Okay, so now you can understand it is a very important part, and there is a many naturally occurring tocopherols. Four of them are actually tocopherols, and other four are the tocotetrienols. So next, about the stability, if we are going to talk about the stability, then although the vitamin E prevents the oxidations of itself destroyed in the oxidation of the UV light. It usually destroys in the presence of the UV light or oxidize itself, but still in our body, it helps to control the oxidation. That means it is used as the antioxidant that can give work as a scavenger. It can wash out all the free radicals that is present inside of our body, and it is a very important role. Rather than this the childbearing factors, the vitamin E's function is a very important functions of the vitamin E. So now the sources of the vitamin D, E, it is a very important part. Tocopherol cannot be synthesized in our body like the vitamin D is usually synthesized in our cholesterol, and it helps to do various functions in our bone. But vitamin E cannot be synthesized in our body. We have to actually eat the foods by which only we can get those vitamin E. Okay, so what are the sources of it? The tocopherol is not synthesized mainly in the vegetable sources. Yes, it is very important part that the vitamin E sources are more or less the vegetative sources. There are very less sources of the animal parts. Mainly, whatever the sources from which we can get the vitamin E, it is usually the the vegetable sources. So the general of tocopherol level in oil increases in the linoleic acid contained increase. If we consume more amount of the linoleic acid, that is very good for our health. The vitamin E content is also will increase, because the vitamin E is fat soluble vitamin. With the fat only it can come to our body. It is also present in cereals, poultry, meat, fish. The tocopherol content in human milk is higher than the cow's milk, because of this, the fertility behavior. Okay, so what are the sources of the vitamin E? Like the foodstuffs in the wheat flour, it is present 6.5 mg percentage. Like in the 100 grams, it is present 6.5%. In the maize flour, it is present 6.2%. In the rice flax, it is present 3.4%. In the red gram dal, it is present 10.2%. In the green gram, it is present 12.4%. In the onion, it is present 1.1%. In the French beans, it is present 8.3%. So you can see every sources are the animal, are the food, plant sources, not animal sources. In the cauliflower, it is present 6.8. Now only to the fat animal sources can be seen. Like in butter, it is present 5.1%. In ghee, it is present 2.8%. This ghee and butter are the only two sources till now we are getting where we can get the vitamin E, right? So the vanaspati, we can also get the 6.7%. From the mustard oil, we can get it 86.2%. So it is a very rich amount. The groundnut oil, 35.9%. And sesam oil, it is 33.1%. So those who are thinking that white oil is better than the mustard oil, they are absolutely wrong. But mustard oil is same good. Like this is not bad. The mustard oil is also good because it contained many of the good vitamins and minerals. And this is very important for our body. So it is good if you are consuming mustard oil. If you are consuming your normal diet made by the mustard oil, it is actually good. It is not, there is nothing bad in it. Okay, so don't think that obviously we have to buy the olive oil because the olive oil is very good. Yes, if you are purchasing the single pressed olive oil or the virgin olive oil, these are already good because it contain a very high sources of the good fats. But still, if you are consuming mustard oil, it is not also very bad because maybe it contains actually more nutrients than the white oil and the sunflower oil. So as a nutrition student, every time when you buy any food item, you can check the back of it. Everything is written, the vitamin contained, the fat contained, the saturated, unsaturated, cholesterol content. Everything is written in the back of the packets. You can check that and then you can understand the what is good for you and what is bad for you. Okay, so make it a practice, like everywhere when you will buy something, any packeted food, you should check, you must check the back portion of it, then you will understand the what are the things it have. Okay, so next, the RDA. The RDA means the recommended dietary allowances. It is not actually clearly written, but still ICMR recommended 0.8 milligram per gram for EFA, like essential fatty acid, because from only that we can get the vitamin E. Okay, and some others suggested 8 mg of tocopherol equivalent for the woman and 10 mg for men can prevent these deficiencies. So after that, we will going to discuss about the functions of the deficiency in the next video. Till then, thank you.